It's 2023 and AI writing tools are everywhere. And one of the most well-known AI writing tools is undoubtedly Jasper. And with Jasper getting a huge series of funding, we thought now would be a good time to compare Jasper versus Content at Scale. On one side, we have Jasper that's been around for some time. And on the other side, we have Content at Scale. And unlike being a generalized AI, Content at Scale focuses strictly on creating excellent quality blog content. So today, we're going to take a deep dive into an article written by Josh Sloan here at Content at Scale, breaking down in both Jasper and Content at Scale. So if you don't know what Jasper is a generalized AI that you're able to use to write blog posts, emails, social media post. Where on the other hand, Content at Scale focuses on creating full-length, high-quality, SEO-optimized articles from just your keywords, and also making sure that the output is human-like and undetectable. So the first thing that we're going to break down is the features of each platform. So if we take a look at this graph that was put together, we have three columns. We have features, Content at Scale, and Jasper. This is where we're going to break down everything and make sure that you have a full picture of what each platform offers. So the first feature that we're focusing on is truly long-form content. Content at Scale produces around 2,000 words per article as an average. Jasper produces on average between 300 and 700 words per article. And this is based off of just using a keyword and letting the AI take over. The next feature is the time it would take you to write 20 articles. So if we take a look at Content at Scale, it's around 20 minutes. That's roughly a minute an article. It's also worth mentioning that each one of those articles are around 2,500 words. The amount of time it takes for you to use Jasper to write the same amount of articles is around 15 hours. Quite a difference. But what about bulk keyword capability? Say you had a bunch of keywords that you wanted to write articles about. Which platform would be best to execute that on? Content at Scale has the ability for you to upload your keywords to the platform and then have the AI take over writing all of your articles for you. On the other hand, Jasper only allows you to put in one single keyword and then have their AI write an article about that keyword. So if you really value your time, Content at Scale is a no-brainer in that feature. Another thing to think about is the technology behind each one of these platforms. Content at Scale uses three AI engines and two natural language and semantic algorithms. On the other hand, with Jasper, they only use one. The reason why this is so important is the quality of the output. Content at Scale is purpose-built for SEO-optimized articles. This means that for blogging and article writing, Content at Scale is going to provide you with way better results than Jasper will. But what happens if you start writing a ton of AI content and Google decides that they want to penalize your site? With Google cracking down on spammy AI content, it's more important than ever that the AI tool that you use safeguards you from any future Google penalizations. If you're using AI to create other things such as social media posts, email copy, your advertisements, YouTube scripts, anything that isn't a blog post, Jasper is an excellent tool for those things. Since Jasper is a generalized AI, it does very well on those other areas. But all of that AI output means absolutely nothing if the content that's produced isn't feature-rich and actually seems like it's written from a human. This is where Content at Scale starts to shine even more. With things like key takeaway boxes, click-to-tweets, FAQs, your headings and featured images, and even your conclusion, all baked into the article that's generated for you. Whereas Jasper, on the other hand, lacks any of those features, leaving it up to you to do more work and dramatically increase the amount of time that it takes for you to produce an article. And the whole point of using AI is to save you time. With every single article generated from Content at Scale, it includes a table of contents. Jasper, on the other hand, doesn't produce a table of contents for your article. One of the most hot-button topics surrounding AI content is plagiarism. After all, the way that AIs learn is from scraping information from all across the internet and then using algorithms that AI produce content based off of what they learned. This could be scary for a lot of people, especially since plagiarism is such a big deal. And that's where Content at Scale has another leg up on top of Jasper. Content at Scale has integrations with Copyscape, one of the leading plagiarism scanners. This is extremely useful, especially if you're concerned about plagiarism. Jasper, on the other hand, does not include that. Most blogs that you come across are built on WordPress. So having a useful WordPress plugin is really good in order for you to create bulk content. Jasper currently has no WordPress plugin. However, Content at Scale does. And this plugin will automatically import your articles and all the changes made to your articles directly to your WordPress site. And what's even better is that this plugin will also do all of your internal linking for you. Once again, saving you a ton of time. The plugin can also automatically create external links to affiliate offers if you're part of an affiliate program. And lastly, what about Google question and answer schema? At the time of this recording, Jasper simply just doesn't pull in that information. On the other hand, Content at Scale inserts FAQs directly into your articles based off of your keyword. This means that your articles will include straight to the point answers for any questions that your users or readers might want to know. One of the biggest differences between Jasper and Content at Scale is Jasper includes over 60 templates that the AI uses to create content for you, whether that's product descriptions for your Amazon listings or the template to explain it to a child. This gives Jasper a set of instructions in order for it to produce content in the style that you want based off that template. Content at Scale takes a completely different approach when it comes to that. Instead of providing templates and models for generalized content, Content at Scale focuses specifically on blog content. This makes the quality of the content output far more predictable, which will result result in you getting higher quality output. The next thing is to dive into the purpose behind each one of these platforms. So if we put the two AI writers head to head, this is what we see. Jasper wants to help marketers and content creators create content faster. And the way that they want to do this is by using the AI to work alongside the person that's using the tool. Content at Scale is for publishers, business owners, and bloggers who want full articles that are ready for review. So the next logical question is, can Jasper produce long form blog content? The answer to that question is yes, it absolutely can, but it's going to require some workarounds and a lot of handholding. To achieve a long form blog post, there's two ways to do it. The first way is to use the blog post workflow. The second way is to use their new one-shot blog post template. What you're seeing on the screen right now is the workflow from Jasper in order for you to create long form content for your blog. And as you can see, there's a lot of steps that you need to go through in order to write a long form blog post. Another thing that we should take a look at is the results coming out of Jasper. And as you can see, it generated 368 words, 5 headings counting the conclusion, and 7 paragraphs. This isn't really what we would consider a long form blog post, unless you consider a few hundred words to be truly a one-shot blog post. If you want to take a look at the content output from Jasper, all you have to do is go down to the description down below where we have a link to a Google Doc that has the output from Jasper. But what about AI detection? How did this article from Jasper fare against an AI detector? The results in the following screenshot speak for themselves, and it's about what you'd expect. We're looking at a score about 52% original. That leaves the probability of it being AI content at 48%, which isn't that good. So now let's talk about the process of creating articles within Content at Scale. Content at Scale has the ability for you to bulk upload your keywords to the site and then have the AI take over and write all of the articles for you. What you're seeing on screen right now is the process that you would go through in order to bulk upload your keywords to our site and have the AI write those articles for you. But how long would it take for the AI to write those articles? Well, Josh thought ahead and he used a timer. It took roughly 1 minute and 15 seconds for it to write the articles. If you want to take a look at one of the unedited articles that Josh generated from Content at Scale, all you have to do is go down to the description and we have a link to it. So let's put the article from Jasper and Content at Scale side by side and see what the articles look like together. As you can see, the article on the left, which is written by Content at Scale, is full of features and looks as if it's written from a human. With things like table of contents, key takeaways, click to tweets, and so much more, it makes your articles actually pop and stand out to the reader. As opposed to the Jasper article, which is just words and headings, there's no real user experience within the article, leaving it up to you to create that part of your article yourself, dramatically increasing the amount of time it takes for you to produce high quality content for your readers. But what happens when we take a Content at Scale article and run it through an AI detector? The screenshot that you're seeing right now tells it all. The unedited content straight out of Content at Scale gets a 99% human score. In a previous update, we announced that we solved AI detection. This means that it's incredibly safe for you to use Content at Scale in your blog. The Content at Scale article also passed the plagiarism test, so you could have peace of mind knowing that none of the content within your article is plagiarized. The last thing we're going to take a look at is the pricing models. Jasper's credits are based on word count, and their plans start around 20,000 words per month. Content at Scale's credits are based off of articles, and the starting plan is 20 articles per month. One of the key differences in these pricing models is since Jasper charges you per word, by the time that you get through your article and you start adding things in, those credits add up fast, meaning that if you were to write a 3,000 word article, it would charge you 3,000 credits. On the other hand, with Content at Scale, one article equals one credit, and each article is going to be around 2,500 words. And included in that article is all of those features, such as your key takeaways, call to actions, your click to tweets, your conclusion, your FAQs, your headings, your meta description, your featured image, all included for you. So you're not constantly using credits in order to create a good, high quality article. We're in the middle of a technology boom when it comes to AI. AI is completely taking over the SEO scene, and search engine optimization as a whole is going to be changed forever due to AI. If you're currently using AI to write your content, I highly suggest that you go to contentatscale.ai and you click on the AI detector. This is a free tool that we put out in order for you to check your content. After all, it's really important that the content that you put on your site is safe and you don't get penalized by Google. The last thing that you want is a big old slap from Google penalizing you for using AI content. So make sure that your content is safe using our AI detector. And if you want full-length, high-quality SEO optimized articles that are undetectable and are rich in features, you can also bulk upload a keyword list to our site and have all the articles written in minutes. I highly suggest that you go to contentatscale.ai and try it for yourself. But writing a ton of articles means nothing if you don't have a good keyword strategy. That's why I highly suggest that you check out this video next, which breaks down one of our favorite research methods for keywords, and that's the avalanche method. It's right there. Go ahead and click on it.